BBD ITM WIE Affinity Group Advisor, Professor Kanika Lamba Ma'am, for providing us these worthwhile opportunities and a room to explore our strength in various fields. Today is the fifth day in the series of our IEEE PES Day celebration. IEEE PES student chapter has organized a competition on innovative idea for project on Clean India, Clean Energy Revolution in association with IEEE UP section. This event is going to be very exciting for everyone as we have our best participants who are already very much excited, and also we have a great personified jury panel with us who will be giving their suggestions as well as entailed result throughout. Encouragement, enthusiasm, and excellency are the major aspects of an organization. With an objective of encouraging the spirit of research and innovation, IEEE BBD ITM, in collaboration with IEEE UP section, feels extremely proud today to host this event. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. It really means a lot to us. All the participants are kindly requested to avoid any kind of nuisance and are instructed to please keep their microphones and videos off during the entire program. Let us take this opportunity and acknowledge you all that our branch has organized over more than 75 events, including Region 10 programs beginning from March 2020 till date, and competitions on various topics including webinar on advanced signal processing technique, IEEE student member development program, and many more. Our branch has also been awarded as the best student branch in the UP section in the year 2020. On the behalf of IEEE BBD ITM branch, I express the gratitude towards everyone who has been attending the programs and are supporting us vigorously. Here is a glimpse of various events organized by our IEEE student branch right from its exceptions. Kindly have a look to it. So, to inaugurate this entire event, first of all, I would like to invite our Honorable Director, BBD ITM Lucknow, Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, sir, for the welcome address. Sir, heading over to you.
Thank you, organizers. Convener of the program, Dr. Khadim, head of the department, as well as branch counselor, Professor Rafiq Ahmed, now on behalf of our management and all other stakeholders of BBD group, including our chairperson, Srimati Alka Das, and President Viras Sagar Dasji, I once again welcome and feel honored as well as privileged to welcome the jury members in particular, who have taken time out of their hectic schedules and they are blessing the occasions with their expertise and wisdom. So I wish all the best to all the participants as well as who are participating in this with enthusiasm. And of course, I'm sure this will give them confidence in time to come to hone their skills and of course, make it relevant as a contribution to the society and environment. So over to Anchor. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for the welcome address. We really appreciate your presence throughout the event. Moving ahead, let me introduce you all, our respected jury members. Dr. Monica Manhotra. Dr. Monica obtained her BE degree in Electrical Engineering from Madan Mohan Malviya Engineering College, Gorakhpur. She received her M.Tech in Digital Communication from UP Technical University and PhD in Electrical Engineering from MNNIT, Allahabad. She has around 20 years of teaching experience and 5 years of has published several technical papers in national and international journals of repute and has guided several MTech scholars. Her research interests are in the field of control system, controller design, and reduced order modeling. She has also published a book on electric circuits with Tata MC Groth-Hill. Next, we have Dr. Nitin Kumar Saxena with us. Dr. Saxena obtained his PhD in electrical engineering in 2016 from National Institute of Technology, Kurukshetra, India, and MTech in Energy Studies in 2009 from Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi. Presently, he is working as Associate Professor in KIET Group of Institute, Delhi NCR, Ghaziabad, India. He has more than 18 years of teaching experience. He has professional acceptability with intellectual teaching exposure as he taught in Foreign University of Ministry of Higher Education, Ethiopia for 2 years. He has demonstrated expert knowledge in the area of power system analysis and excellent knowledge and skill in mathematical optimization and advanced control techniques through more than 40 papers published in SCI journal and conferences. He has published 5 books and book chapter with international publishers like Elsevier and Springer. He has guided 2 MTech theses. He has high-level programming capabilities in MATLAB and Python language. He has good writing skills and excellent communication skills as verified by qualifying IELTS examinations. He has ability to participate in the planning, organizing, and delivery of multifaceted programs involving partnership with a variety of internal and external organizations. Moving ahead, we have Dr. Vikas Solanki
around us. Kirti. Yes, Kirti. Sir? Actually, today we have only 3 judges. Okay, now you can read the profile of Dr. Anurag Dwivedi and after that close it. Okay.
Sure, sir. Thank you. Last, we have Dr. Anurag Dwivedi with us. Dr. Dwivedi received his MTech degree in Power Electronics and Drives from Madan Mohan Malviya Engineering College, Gorakhpur in 2013 and PhD degree in Electrical Engineering, funded by Technical Education Quality Improvement Program Phase 3 from Madan Mohan Malviya University of Technology, Gorakhpur in 2019. He has published 42 research papers in international journals, 13 papers presented in the national as well as international conferences, and filing one patent. He has received Best Research Paper Award in 1 national and in 2 international conferences. He has published 2 books in the field of electrical engineering and technology. Currently, he is working as an assistant professor and dean in Bansal Institute of Engineering and Technology. He has total 9 years of a teaching experience. He is the editorial board member of the international journal and reviewer of many reputed journals such as IEEE Industry Application Society in International Journal on Electrical Engineering and Informatics Indonesia, Global Journal USA, and active reviewer of IEEE international and national conferences. He is an active volunteer and organized many programs of national as well as international level such as webinars, conferences, etc. He has authored more than 50 in various national and international conferences and journals. He has delivered expert lectures in the field of power electronics and drives. Dr. Anurag has attended and participated in more than 30 webinars and conferences. His research area of interest includes power electronics, control system, multi-level inverters, and smart grid. I thank all the jury members for their continued support and cooperation throughout the event. It means a lot. Thank you. Proceeding towards the presentation competition, we had received a number of presentations for this competition, and we really appreciate the commendable efforts of the participants, but unfortunately it is not possible to conduct all this program for such a large number of participants virtually. So our organizing team committee has selected four candidates who will be taking part in this competition. So now I call upon our first participant, Mr. Hitansh Dwivedi. Mr. Hitansh, you can now start sharing your screen. Thank you.
Is my screen is visible?
Yes, your screen is visible.
Good morning, everyone present over here. I am Hitansh Dwivedi, BTech first year student. My project topic is solar panel ventilator system. I have made this project with my team Shivani Mishra, who designed the pictures for the event, and slide background is designed by Akansha Chandra. This is my project idea. We can make a ventilator project using a solar panel system. In my idea, there is a ventilator by which we can use the solar panel, connect the solar panel with it. So we can use, if the light goes off in the hospitals, as we can see the situation of today in COVID-19. The hospitals are already full and not having any type of space to keep the patients in the hospital. So they can put them into on the terrace of the hospital or in the campus of the hospital. So by this they need some ventilators, but for the connection of the ventilator they need electricity or generator. If the electricity is not present, so the generator is used, but generator is some way is polluting the earth and is not good for health also, and it is expensive also. So I have an idea to attach a ventilator system with a solar panel. One solar panel can connect 2-3 ventilators at a time. Ventilator first connect to the DC-DC voltage, DC-DC converter, which is a high frequency power conversion circuit that used to high frequency switching and inductor transformation and capacitor to smooth switching. It is used for the inverter using without batteries. So when the inverter connected to it, so by inverter we can connect a ventilator. So by this we can move further. You can see, so by this we can decrease the pollution of the society. The pollution can get decreased, and the desired outcome is it decreases the expenses of the patients also, and it is eco-friendly also. And in the evening time, we can use generator sometime also. Thank you very much. This is my overall image of the project. You can see the ventilator is here, which is connected to the solar panel. Thank you. If you have any question, you may ask.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Hello.
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 Yes, hello. Sir. You are completely audible.
Can you listen to me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you listen to me?
Yes, sir.
मेरी आवाज आ रही है आपको?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah, but आपको ये जानना चाहती हूँ, your idea is good. So, how you are planning to implement it?
Sir, by using by connection of the solar panel with the first series to the DC circuit, which is DC-DC converter, by which we can.
Theoretically, your idea is good. मैं ये पूछना चाह रहा हूँ कि आप इसको बनाना चाह रहे हो एज अ हार्डवेयर, आप इसको जो है प्लान कर रहे हो अपने फाइनल ईयर में?
Yes sir, it's not first year sir, but I will plan for it.
Okay, so since you are in first year, so I will suggest you please collect the data regarding the size of the panel and size of the battery, size of other things. In next time, whenever you present your project idea in front of any committee, if you will give some tabular form data that so much panels will be required, the rating of the panel will be this much, and similarly the converter size and rating of battery, then it will be more worthful. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so since you are the first year student, so I'm expecting next time whenever you will go for any project presentation, you will include these slides also in your presentation.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, Hitansh.
Good morning, ma'am.
Can you show the first slide?
Yes, ma'am.
No, the second one, in which you have the circuit diagram. Circuit is there.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, as on date, this is just an idea.
Yes,
but just let me know that. Have you studied about the implementation part of this idea, whether it will be giving good results or not?
Yes, I'm little bit I have studied, because by this exactly one thing is that the money level which the patient gets, the expenses will decrease firstly. And
is it an already existing project, or there's something new in it?
No, I think there is something new in it, because I have also thought for automatic disposable dustbin also, but it is already implemented, so I have started for this idea. Like you can see in the circuit, this is a DC converter by which it is converted the circuit into the light charging, LED charging light, which is by which
okay. Do you know the what is the function of DC to DC converter? What does it
do? Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, they are high frequency power conversion circuits that use high frequency switching and indicators, transformers and capacitor to smooth out switching noise into regulated DC voltage. Like if in inverter we for connecting to the solar panel.
No, I am just asking, what is DC to DC converter?
Ma'am, DC to DC converter is used to convert the switching and inductor transformer into the smooth switching without noise, switching noise into the regulated DC voltage. Ma'am, like it to connect the solar panel with the inverter without battery. It is directly, means not AC current is required for this. You can directly connect it, because there is inverter is also there, but it is very expensive. So for this, to decrease the expense, I have used a DC converter, DC-DC converter. The inverter which comes directly to connect to the solar panel is about 86,000.
Okay, so in this circuit, first, what is the first device which you have used? Can you tell on that?
Ma'am, first device we have used the DC converter. First, we have used the solar panel.
I am asking about the circuit diagram which you have shown in the slide.
Yes, ma'am.
And just let me know
this is a transformer, ma'am.
Okay, what is it doing? Is it a step up or step down transformer?
Ma'am, it is a step down transformer.
Okay, then after that, what is there?
it's connect going to the connection with the resistors and by which it's connected to the inverter, like diodes are present here.
Nahi, what are these diodes doing? What is this circuit called?
Smart inverter, it's rectifier.
Yes,
actually, you have tried to make something which is you have practically not implemented it. So at least theoretically, things should be clear to you. Yes, if you are presenting a circuit diagram, then must be knowing about the every device which you have connected in the circuit. At least the basic knowledge. I understand that you are a first year student. And your effort is very good. Being in first year only, you have tried to show a project which normally the students of final year do. That is okay. But then this is advisable to you that if you present your project or your presentation in front of anyone, then please, whatever circuit, whatever equipments you are using, you should be having some basic knowledge about them. So, whatever questions I have asked you related to the various devices in the this circuit, most of the answers were not correct. So, I appreciate your effort. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Hitansh. Next participant is Mr. Prince Verma. Verma, over to you, Mr. Prince.
Thank you, Kriti. Hello.
Your screen is visible, Prince.
More visible.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, Prince.
Is my screen is visible to you?
Yes, it is visible.
Good morning, all respected sir and all the jury members. Myself, Prince Verma, and I am a student of BTech, third year electrical department. And I have proposed a project on the generation of electricity using road transport pressure. So this one is the introduction that what is the requirement for making this project. Like I have these are wasted, like vehicles are running on the roads. The most amount of energy of its kinetic energy is lost in the air, and it also it creates a CO2s which is harmful to our environment. So it is a method, alternate method to preserve the renewable energies. So for the reduction of carbon dioxide emission, renewable energies are considered as proper alternative energy. Here the renewable energy resources which are considered to be the solar, wind, biomass and marine current, which are less harmful to the environment, attracting a wide attention to researchers in design and development of renewable energy conversion system. As a car passes over a speed breaker, most of car kinetic energy will be wasted as heat in it. On the other hand, to ensure the security of the populated areas of street, the speed breaker are required, whatever we used, electrical car or the car consuming gas oil. So what we are going to do, that we are focusing on the fixed speed breaker at the street, since a high amount of vehicle kinetic energy is wasted there. There are thousands of crowded cities with enormous flow of vehicles, offer high amount of energy can be considered as near to the urban resources of energy. So this one slide for the about the idea, what the basic idea I have considered, that we have also seen speed breaker generation called as SBGs for the extraction of kinetic energy. vehicle flows in the street, like you have seen in the diagram, like vehicle is going past through the speed breaker, and the, below the speed breaker there is a mechanism. As you see the first slide, the diagram is shown. On below the speed breaker there is a spring connected to it, and through the spring there is a chain and socket attachment. Through this, if the pressure is applied on that that part, then in this slide, then the this ball bearing will try to rotate this shaft, and through shaft a connected chain will rotate this shaft to, and which it is connected to the DC generator, and through DC generator line is connected to through the battery, and through the battery is, and the battery which were constructed or maybe installed in the street poles. So when automobile vehicle are running on a specified speed breaker, this will create pressure on the pressure lever which is kept under specialized speed breaker. As a result, flywheel will rotate, and this rotation of flywheels cause to DC generate to produce electricity. This electricity can be stored by a rechargeable battery. By charging the battery, the produced or stored electricity is used for lighting bulb during night time on the roadside. Like I have seen in the rural areas, most of the street lights are not present, and which are present they generally do not glow in the night because of the some fault. So when we are going to construct this on the speed breaker, there could be a benefit for the night time. The people could easily see the way. And this one is the project outcome. Like in the given diagram, battery, power, vehicle, electricity charge. And through that, hello? Hello?
Yes, Prince.
Is I'm audible?
Yeah.
Okay. Like in this diagram, you have seen that the electricity generated through the SBGs, which is directly connected to the grid, and through grid the electric charging batteries and batteries powered vehicles. So EVs charging could be the best option. Like we are going to more focusing on the EVs charging related, that on constructing a pole on which a battery should be constructed, and through that generated power the EVs could be easily charged, and also the street light could be glow in the night time. In the coming days, it will prove a great boon to the world, since it will save a lot of electricity of power plant that get wasted in illuminating the street light. As a conventional source are depleting very fast, then it's a time to think of alternative. We got to save the power gained from conventional source for efficient use. So this idea is not only provide alternative, but also add to the economy of the country. Now vehicular traffic in big cities is more causing a problem to the human. Like I've seen that it causes a CO2 and a CO gas, which could be the major problem for creating a global warming on the earth. But this vehicular traffic can be utilized for proper generation by means of new techniques called power pump. This, it is an advantage. It does not utilize any external source. Now the time has come to put forth this type of innovative idea, and also researchers have done to upgrade its implementation. Implication. In future, if the flywheel speed control device and voltage protection device are added with a large generation power, it could be a model over the world. Also, modification of the design project, the efficiency of whole system can be increased, and increasing the capacity of generator and applying more weight. Thank you, sir.
Okay, good morning, Prince.
Good morning, ma'am.
First of all, you have taken more time for the presentation. I think it was 3 minutes only. Now, one question for you. that how much power can be generated from a single car when it is passing through the speed breaker. Do you have any idea?
Ma'am, actually I haven't created any hardware diagram, so I don't have any idea about the how much power
it generates. But then this is finally what you are saying is that we are going to utilize this power for lighting up the LEDs which are installed, street lights. So if you are, if you have to use this power, this energy for lighting the street lights, then you should have an idea about how much,
ma'am,
whether you are gaining something or not.
Ma'am, not only the single speed breaker, but also if we installed a 4 to 5 and with this series through the
battery. That's okay. That all you will be doing when you will have an idea about the output from one speed breaker. If you find that this much power is less, this is not sufficient to light the street lights, then in that case you will be installing more. But for that, basic idea has to be there. कितनी यूनिट जनरेट हो है इस काम को करने से, ये आपको पता होना चाहिए.
मैम, but it is possible only when
because this idea is this
idea. The hardware model.
Because this idea is also not new. This is an already existing. This is an already existing.
In the South African countries, you using this method. It is not applied in India.
That's okay. So you have taken the idea from somewhere, na? You have not developed it. Then you should have taken the other facts also. Anyways, thank you from my side. Anyone thank else you, can? Okay.
Any mathematical relation between kinetic energy and output power?
Kinetic energy and output power
relation. Input is your kinetic energy.
Yes, sir.
Your mechanical energy, and output your electrical energy.
Yes, sir.
Relation between. Yes.
Sir, relation in power. Sorry, sir. I'm not remembering the formula.
Okay. Thank you, Prince.
Thank you, Prince. Now, next, I call upon Ms. Neha Tiwari with her presentation. Over to you, Neha. Hello.
Yeah, Kriti, one minute.
Okay.
It's shown. My PPT is shown.
Yeah, it's showing.
Hello.
Yes, it is showing.
Yeah. A warm good afternoon to all. Myself, Neha Tiwari, third year student. PBD item. Now I am going to present my ideas on the clean energy revolutions, which is electric generator. According to the government of the India, the agriculture sector is responsible for 16.2% of the total greenhouse gas at in such institute. IARI have indicated that the possibilities of the laws 225 MMMT in the below regions with every 1 degree Celsius rise in the temperatures. मैं rural areas से belong करती हूँ और मैं यहाँ पे
देखती हूँ कि जो भी एग्रीकल्चर से रिलेटेड होता है तो वहां पे डीजल और पेट्रोल यूज होता है। जैसे ट्रैक्टर भी यहाँ पे आते हैं तो वो भी डीजल और पेट्रोल से ही चलते हैं। और जो भी यदि खेत में पानी चलाना हो तो वहां पे भी यहाँ पे डीजल और पेट्रोल से ही चलते हैं, क्योंकि ग्रीन हाउस एमिशन बहुत ज्यादा घटते हैं। तो मैं एक दिन ट्रैक्टर को देखकर सोची यदि इसको इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर में यदि बदला जाए तो क्यों ना ग्रीन हाउस को जो गैसेस हैं वो कम हो जाए। तो यहाँ पे सॉल्यूशन है कि यदि हम इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर जो कि हम लोग बनाने चले तो वहां पे मैंने एस्टिमेट किया था तो वहां पे 1 लाख के करीब आ रहा था। और वो कैसे बनेगा, यहाँ पे यदि वेस्ट मटेरियल से हम लोग वो करते हैं या सोलर पैनल यूज करते हैं उसको कन्वर्ट करेंगे फिर एनर्जी थ्रू हम लोग इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर जो हम लोग बनाएंगे उसको वो करेंगे। क्योंकि ड्यू टू द रिडक्शन ऑफ द फ्यूल कंजप्शन द इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर आर द इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर द फार्मिंग सिंस दे ऑपरेट ऑन द बैटरी मेकिंग इकोनॉमिकल इवन एज ए फार्मलैंड द इनकम बीइंग बूस्टेड बाय द यूज ऑफ द टेक्नोलॉजी more can be done to solve burden on the farmer since they are the quieter and can be increased productions at the lower cost and the electrical energy produced by the wind sun waste material and the animal manure and ensured to be futurist solutions for the reducing pollutions and the dependency on the fossil fuel kyunki abhi hum log यदि ग्रीन हाउस गैसेस को कम करने के लिए सोचते हैं तो मेनली हम लोग सोचते हैं कि कार को इलेक्ट्रिक कार में चेंज कर दे या कोई भी व्हीकल्स छोटा मोटा व्हीकल्स को उसको चेंज कर दे। लेकिन हम लोग सेक्टर में नहीं देखते हैं कि वहां पर भी डीजल और पेट्रोल यूज होते हैं, क्यों ना उस डीजल और पेट्रोल को यदि हम लोग इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर में बदल दे या जो भी इक्विपमेंट यूज हो रहे हैं उसके थ्रू हम लोग देखे तो आई थिंक इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर बी द सॉल्यूशंस फॉर द एग्रीकल्चर। हेलो कीर्ति।
हाँ हेलो।
या प्रेजेंटेशन इज ओके। या
ओवर टू यू जूरी मेंबर्स फॉर योर क्वेश्चंस।
नेहा, ये आपने 1 लाख कैसे कैलकुलेट किया बजट? कुछ आपने डाटा दिखाया नहीं, आपने कैलकुलेट किया था?
सर मैंने मतलब यहाँ पे मैंने मतलब दिखाया नहीं है, लेकिन मैं बैठकर कर यही कैलकुलेट कर रही थी कि अभी हम लोग वेस्ट मटेरियल टू डायरेक्ट मतलब इलेक्ट्रिक ट्रैक्टर भी बनाएंगे, चार्जर भी बनाएंगे, कन्वर्टर और जो भी सोर्सेस हम लोग लेंगे या तो सोलर एनर्जी के थ्रू हम लोग चार्ज करें चार्जर को और या तो वेस्ट मटेरियल के थ्रू चार्ज करें, तो कुल मिलाकर 1 लाख के करीब पड़ रहा था
ट्रैक्टर की कास्ट इंक्लूड करके।
या सर, क्योंकि हम लोग ट्रैक्टर हैवी नहीं बनाना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि यहाँ पे रूरल एरिया में सर हैवी बनाने के मतलब कि जल्द वहाँ पे जा नहीं पाता है। यदि छोटा ट्रैक्टर रहेगा तो हम लोग इजिली
सोलर की कास्ट कैसे
सर हम लोग यदि छोटा ट्रैक्टर वो करेंगे
नहीं, इसमें आपने इंक्लूड किया कन्वर्टर भी है तो कास्ट आपके पास है? सोलर पैनल कितने कास्ट का होगा आपका? आपने तो
सर,
बताया
आई थिंक 30-40 का मैं वो सोची थी, क्योंकि अभी छोटा ही मतलब वो
30-40
बड़े लेवल पे उतना तो मैंने
चार्जर पॉइंट आप बनाएंगे उसके बाद ये ट्रैक्टर की कास्ट।
यस
सर, पावर कितने हॉर्स पावर का होगा आप ट्रैक्टर आपका?
सर अभी इतने तो मतलब कैलकुलेशन नहीं हुई थी, लेकिन मतलब मैं कैलकुलेट मतलब ऐसे छोटे में कर रही थी तो इतना मतलब कि वन मतलब 1 लाख या 1.5 लाख तो लग ही जाएगा तो पूरी ट्रैक्टर बनाने में।
ओके थैंक यू।
नेहा,
यस मैम,
यू हैव शोन अ कन्वर्टर हियर, व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस कन्वर्टर?
मैम यहाँ पे कन्वर्टर जो भी यदि हम लोग यहाँ पे वेस्ट मटेरियल लेंगे
तो क्या लेंगे वो वेस्ट मटेरियल क्या होगा?
मैम यदि वेस्ट मटेरियल में हम लोग डंग भी ले सकते हैं, हम लोग जो भी ग्रेडेबल मतलब जो भी डिकम्पोज हो जाए वेस्ट मटेरियल में, हाँ जैसे लीव्स हुए, पत्ती हुई है, ये सभी बहुत सारे इधर मैम मिल जाते हैं।
फिर क्या होगा? तो फिर आगे बताइए।
प्रोसेसिंग, यस मैम, इसको प्रोसेसिंग को 20 डेज लगेंगे, हम लोग स्टेप लेंगे, हाँ तो अभी 20 डेज इसको डिकम्पोज या ये सब करने में जो भी मशीनरी लगा के हम लोग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी।
पापा से कहो अभी मैं बना देती हूँ, 2 मिनट रुक जाओ, मैं सब बना देती हूँ, 2 मिनट रुक जाओ। ओके एंड so you are using a solar panel as well as you are using this waste material also, both of them you are using?
Yeah.
I think your voice is not clear or there is an issue with my network?
No ma'am, her voice
no, ma'am.
Is
I think unclear. My network, sorry ma'am, my network,
so it's okay, not possible.
मैं रूरल एरिया में हूँ मैम, इसलिए अभी नेटवर्क इश्यू चल रही है।
सो ऑल द बेस्ट टू यू, वहाँ पे रह के आप इस ट्रैक्टर के बारे में और पढ़ाई करो अभी, एंड
मैम मैं कुछ एग्रीकल्चर के सेक्टर में है,
हाँ उसको प्रैक्टिकली इम्प्लीमेंट करने की कोशिश करिए आप, ठीक है? ऑल द बेस्ट टू यू, ओके, थैंक यू मैम।
थैंक यू नेहा तिवारी। Now, our last participant of today's event, Mr. Avril Das Srivastav. Come forward, please.
Hello.
Yes, Avril, you are audible.
Good morning, all respected dignitaries, jury member, and all my dear friends. Myself, Aviral Das Srivastav, and my teammate Akriti Kushwaha are in second year pursuing BTech in Electrical Engineering at BBDITM Lucknow. As we all know, the current scenario in which we are living is very disastrous for all the living beings and atmosphere as well. The pollution which is constantly being contaminated in the environment where we are living is very poisoning for the future generation. So we have designed a device, or we can say a machine, which is capable of solving our problem up to very much. Next, please. We have named this device as Avtar, a super drone. Avtar is designed in such a way that it will never harm the environment, rather than it will be behaving like a savior for the environmental issues, either global warming or pollution for all living beings and atmosphere. This device is themed at clean energy revolution. Next slide, please. Now, we must know about the requisites of the Avtar. We need a powerful drone. A drone is a flying robot that can be remotely controlled. In Avtar, we will require some powerful drone that could be capable of carrying a big air purifier, which would be having sensor on all sides that would account to no crashing, highly high power efficient drone will be more preferred. Next, we need a air purifier. Heavy air purifier are equipped to increase the air circulation, generate low noise, multiple stages of filtration, and filter up to 99.7 of microbial dust particles. Air purifier can also help to filter those smoke, dust, and small pollutant material from the environment, and as a result, reduce the global warming. Next, we will require solar panels. Solar panels use sunlight as a source of energy to generate direct electricity. While the drones would be flying in the air, it would be getting direct sun rays during daytime. Hence, they would be capable of self-charging. PV panels should be that much capable that it should keep the drone charged so that it could fly at least 12 hours a day. And last, the most important, we need a control room. A control room that would be working as a municipal department. Sometimes some stations must be created to have full control over the flying drones. That stations must have full GPS record of the drones that would be on work. These stations must be kept an eye on the technicalities of the flying drones. That from the control room itself, from the control room itself, it should be predicted that which kind of problem a drone could be facing in future, so that it could be brought back to the station. Next slide, please. And then we must know about the dependencies of the avatar, the machine. We need a high-tech drone well-equipped with sensors and technologies that could fulfill the need. Power is required by the drone and air purifier to run. That this power is provided by the sun. Hence, this machine can only fly during the daytime and in clear weather. This machine can fly up to certain range, so that control drone should be on knee to keep an eye on that machine, that whether it is in range or not. Next, we should talk about future of avatar. Global warming and pollution related problems can be resolved up to very much large extent by this device. No loss of any kind of natural resource or any form of energy. Hence, this device will never harm the environment, neither today nor in future. With the passing of time and increasing of avatars, we will lead to availability of device at quite cheaper rate. Thus, we will get purified air on each corner of Earth. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
आवाज आ रही है?
Yes, sir.
आपने बताया है कि आपका जो सुपर ड्रोन है, it will not pollute the environment.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay? So, will you elaborate what is electronic wave, e-waves?
Sir, e-waves are generated from the electronic devices which are using network. So, it will not pollute. I'm not talking about that. It will not create e-waves. Definitely, it will create e-waves. But the air pollution, that is the main problem of the environment and for all the human beings or living beings. That problem can be resolved by this machine. And that is all my ideas all about.
But you must also consider the part of electronic waves. Otherwise, you please choose the words very correctly. And if you are claiming that it will not create any harm to the environment, no? So that is question mark for your statement, number one. And number two, you see your first slide. In first slide, you put what is this device. Okay. So in future, do not please use such kind of a statement in your presentation, in any presentation. Because you are the presenter, no? So you should not put a question mark on your first slide. If you are putting a question mark on your first slide, it will not give a good image of your presentation. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. So this is as a student, I am only giving you some idea how can you make your presentation in the best way. Okay.
Okay.
So these are my suggestions. Take in them as a suggestion and try to improve in your next time. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So, good morning, Aviral.
Good morning, ma'am.
Can you show the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and after this, what is there? Next one? Okay, come back. You have not discussed about the technology, what you are using.
Ma'am, I'm not getting what you're asking.
No, something.
I'm just using a powerful drone that is equipped with sensors.
How it is actually doing the task that you have not shown.
Ma'am, it is using air purifier. The air purifier that is already existing in the world. And those air purifier would be performing the task which I'm aiming at.
Okay. So you are simply using an air purifier and with the help of the drone, you are trying to be in the air. That's all you are doing.
Yes, ma'am. And that drone is chargeable. That would be using solar panel.
Your voice is not clear, Raviral. I'm not able to understand. Okay, then. Thank you.
Hello, Abhiran. आपकी आवाज इतनी आ रही बेटा, सिग्नल वीक है क्या? ओके, मे बी सम प्रॉब्लम इन दिस फ्रंट साइड.
हेलो.
ओके, थैंक. हेलो अविरल.
हेलो, गॉट डिस्कनेक्टेड ड्यू टू सम.
यू वांट टू कंटिन्यू?
Yeah, if possible.
Okay.
Abhiral, if you are connected, please answer to the ma'am question. Abhiral?
Yeah.
If you are connected,
yes, ma'am. I was saying, I was saying that this drone is made. This drone would be carrying air purifier. And it would be having the capability of self-charging, means it would be generating electricity for itself and it would be flying in the sky. We will through the control rooms, we will be giving some initial power to it so that it can start flying. And then it would be generating, because in the air, we cannot supply constantly power to it for so that it could fly. But for that purpose, it would be self-charging, and during evening time, it should be coming back to the stations, control rooms, and that is all. They would be performing the task during at least 12 hours a day. We will, ma'am, the idea is just simply that we could buy, we are buying thousand, we are spending lakhs of money to buy car and polluting the environment, so we can also invest some money for some. Initially, it would be costlier to create some this type of technical high tech device, but it would be beneficial for ourselves only.
Okay, I got your point. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
But Abhiral, I'll suggest that air purifier through drone will be a costly matter. So in place of putting it on drone, if we will put not such kind of device, then it will be more effective in terms of the money. You see, air purifier is available in the market in different way. So I don't think it will be more beneficial when we are putting it on drone. Because you see, you have told in the presentation also that the range of your drone is not so much. So for covering the small area, it is better to go with the alternate method of air purification rather than the drone. Okay. It is my submission about your project. Thank you. Do you want to correct me?
sir, I agree with your point, but I think it should be capable of air purification, because in many cities we don't have that much place.
From your idea, I have one idea in my mind, that if suppose the police administration having some of fire administration knows some problem in a particular area, then they have some kind of device, they can send directly from their office. Suppose there is some fire problem in the city, and these fire police having some idea through some GPS or something else, and they can send the drone from their office directly to that particular position. So in that way, your project may be worth. It may be worthful. So you can think in that way. That will give something different and some new flavor. Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay. I would be making a project on this from next time.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye. Thank you, Avril. Thank you to all the participants for your presentations. Coming to the end of today's event, attendees are requested to fill in the feedback form link provided in the chat box section. Now, I would like to invite Professor Dr. Khadim Mohan Siddiqui up on stage. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Anchor. Actually, now I will request to all the dignitaries and participants, we are sharing the new Zoom link, and the valedictory function will start from there. So please now, Suryansh, now you can close the link, and I am going to share new link to all the dignitaries, all the juries. Okay.
Thanks for joining. Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you.